Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Retro Collective Podcast, where we taste worse than the jelly beans that John eats on his show. My name is Jerry, a.k.a. SBK Retro.
And I'm PJ, a.k.a. What the fuck is this nerd shit?
My name is Mike, a.k.a. X the X Dane X.
You have a problem with your name?
And I'm John Riggs. Hold on, an X isn't that.
Yeah.
I do the same thing when I say his name.
John.
X the X Dane X. Crazy. No, because only because X the X Dane X was already taken. I'm John Blue Riggs on Instagram. But John. Well,
why don't we all have that name?
Let's remind me about the already,
Instagram names and just put tons of X's in there.
We won't be able to find anyone.
How many X's?
Yeah, I wanted X Dane X, but that was already taken, so.
He originally was going to go with Linda Lovelace, but that was taken also. Alright, so, everyone, welcome back to the reboot of the Retro Collective Podcast. One of the first things that we need to bring up today are the Retro Collective shirts. We've got another batch coming out.
Yeah.
New design by the mysterious Rockbow, which looks fantastic. How does everyone feel about that design?
It looks like fresh. Sex on cocaine.
Say it looks like cocaine?
I like it.
Sex on cocaine.
Sex on cocaine. Okay. Well, I hope when I'm walking down the street, somebody goes, "Oh, you're into video games? You want to go do some coke behind the Quicker Liquor and let me blow you?" Yes!
You can't do a line off your penis because it's too small.
Yeah, that's not what you say when you're choking on it.
And we're back!
Reasons why John quick. Will be divorced soon is this Retro Collective shirt.
Perhaps.
So, yeah, we have the shirt coming out. It's going to be made by Co-op Clothing, which a lot of y'all have Co-op Clothing shirts out there on the Instagram. I know I have all of them except for one, and that one's being sent to me soon because I'm a shirt collector, apparently. So it's going to be made by Co-op Clothing. There should be a pre-order up on his site soon. We're doing all the pre-orders through his site to keep everything organized. Right now, it does look like they are going to be $20 shipped a shirt, but we are actually trying to do, if you buy two shirts, you get it for $30 shipped instead of what would have been $40. So pretty much, you pay no shipping on either shirt. You just get the price of the two shirts.
There you go.
So for everyone who...
Or buy one.
Yeah.
Get one at half price.
Yeah, something like that. But it basically, because I know like people like me who buy shirts for me, my girlfriend, my roommate, my mom, my dad, my brother. I buy shirts for like everyone in my family when it comes to RC shirts. That it's a really good deal for me, and it's also a really good deal for anyone who wants to buy two to have one and save the other for all our sealed collectors out there. So,
it's not a bad idea.
So that'll be really good. Like I said, pre-orders will be up soon. We hope to get all these shirts made and shipped before March. They are pre-order only. Once the pre-orders are done, which when we announce it, we'll say the pre-orders were on for like 2 weeks or 3 weeks to you can be able to get all your pre-orders in. We are doing that to A, keep the cost of the shirts down, so that way we know exactly how many we're making and how many and what sizes and all that good stuff. It helps keep costs down. That's why, if you make just one shirt, like through Redbubble, it costs like $30-$40 a shirt. So we won't have to do that. We will have international shipping, of course. You'll know international shipping will cost more because, you're not in America and there's something wrong with you. We will have up to like 5X or something. I don't know if it's 5X tall or if it's just regular 5X. I will find that out and let y'all know as soon as possible, because I know there are some people who can't just have a 5X. They need it 5X tall. Because apparently all shirts are made the same size unless you put tall in there. So,
that's and that about sums up the standard refrigerator collector.
Yeah.
They're either like super small, super scrawny, or they're 5X tall. There's no just like some random dude.
He's
like, eh, you know.
We have giants that collect video games.
It seems like it. Now, my question is, because it seems like so many of the retro collectors live in the South, will there be a tank top version available?
I feel like that's a shot towards me, John, because you don't wear tank tops.
It's a loaded question right there. I know, because I live in the Pacific Northwest.
Yeah. As much as I would love one, at this moment, no. It's going to be just the shirt, short-sleeved. I will talk to Randy and see if they're... if it would cost too much to have other options.
Hoodies.
Oh, I'd do a hoodie.
Hoodies would be great, but I don't know what the cost of a hoodie would be. I plan on having Randy on here at some point to talk about co-op clothing, talk about everything he does. And at that point, we can just drill him with questions and put him on the fence.
You know what? You know what, Randy? If you're listening, Randy, I want a co-op miniskirt. Make it happen.
Co-op miniskirt. You know what's sad is I know that's not for your girlfriend. It's for you to prance around. You're in some weird Fudanari shit.
You know what, Randy? Randy, if you make it, I will take an Instagram video of me singing I'm So Pretty in it while frolicking.
And we lost all our viewers.
Yep, all both of them.
Man, my mom was a really big fan of this show, too. So, yeah. That's up. What's up with the shirts, guys. We'll have more information as we get a little bit closer. We should be opening pre-orders within a week. And the only difference to the shirt from the logo is you'll see the Bad Taste logo, which is Rockbow's logo, on there. You will also see the Co-op clothing logo on the shirt. They're small. They're just kind of fitted in there to the corner. But they look nice, so shirts will be coming up very soon, and I'm super excited for another shirt because it's been a long time.
Also a new logo.
It has been a long time.
Yeah. Rockbow has been working on that logo forever, and I've been waiting for it for a long time. In fact, all y'all can probably remember me talking about it in, like, November, I think. Maybe
even it was a while ago.
Maybe even September. So, but Rockbow and all his genius made an awesome logo for us. And I'm stoked that I really get upset when people call the controller a Wii controller. Because I'm like, how dare you not have knowledge on Famicom controllers?
Well, it's supposed to be generic enough.
Controller.
Either way, I love the shirt. And I love Rockbow. And
the Atari Lynx is a controller.
The Atari Lynx itself is a controller. Was it the Atari Lynx that was used in a movie as a controller? That stupid Surf Ninjas movie? Or was it a Sega?
Oh, which?
The Surf Ninjas.
The Surf Ninjas.
Yeah.
Game Gear was in Jackie Chan's Rumble in the Bronx. Will Smith's Enemy of the State had the Turbo Express. So I think it was Surf Ninjas that had the links.
I think it was. That was a terrible movie. Oh, I should watch that again.
Right.
Was it Rob?
Yeah.
Rob Schneider played his greatest role in that movie as himself. So it was all good. So next question is, we'll start with PJ. PJ, what did you pick up retro video game wise this week?
And where did you pick it up?
And who did you get it?
I picked it up. You guys can go to hell.
I didn't catch any more of that. Take the penis out of your mouth and then reach it.
I'm sorry about that. Long story short, me and a couple friends, we went out hunting and we were all over New Jersey. And we went to this one shop and it was terrible. And I asked them, you know, we're not from this area. Do you know of any other shops? And they're like, yeah, the shop keeps a mean old lady and all their games are overpriced. And I was like, you know what? Fuck it. Let's go. And so we went. It was like 15 minutes down the road from the shop we were at. And we walk in, there's just games everywhere. It was like an episode of Hoarders. You could barely walk. And so we're looking around at everything, and my friend Anthony, he turns to me, and he says, you know, there's NES games over there. I was like, I'm not looking for NES games right now. He's like, I want to complete my PS2 RPG collection. And he's like, no, they're in box on the ground. He's like, I think I see Battletoads. And I was like, all right. So I turn and look, and there's a whole bunch of games. And I was like, these prices are probably going to fucking suck. Pull out Battletoads complete in box, and it's like $20. I was like, all right, then. So I keep going through, and then I see a sealed Mario is missing for $24.95. And I'm like, what? So I shit my pants in the middle of the store. Spaghetti falls out on me everywhere. And I said, I don't know what's going on. And so I pick up like 10 or 12 games. I just walk up to the counter, and I'm like, excuse me. I was like, you know, I'd like to purchase these, whatever, whatever, whatever. And she's like, well, the more you buy, the more you save. So my total was like originally 70-something. I'm sorry, I'm trying not to laugh. And she started knocking money off of it, and I'm just standing there, and my eyes turn into dollar signs. And she even throws in Silent Service for free. I get in the car, I was like, I need to pump Mars.
That's about the right price.
And like, after like 5 hours investigating, figures it's between $250 and $350. And I shat bricks the entire ride back to my house. All that for $60 was amazing.
Okay.
You do a lot of shitting in public.
Yeah, I'm not going game hunting with PJ. He just shits everywhere. Anthony, how do you deal with this? Wait, if you shit just picking up games, what do you do when you come? Because I'm starting to feel bad for Sarah here.
You already know what I do when I come.
Yeah, that's true. You think I'm a little teapot. Fucking weird.
Now, if you run a store and someone walks up to your counter smelling of shit with a couple games, are you just gonna give them a hell of a deal to get them the hell out of the store?
Now we know PJ's secret.
Yeah.
That's exactly what it was.
Here, take $10 off. Get out.
But there's still more that I have to go back and get. Like, I didn't have money to buy everything I wanted. There's that much there.
Nice.
Have a hearty lunch before.
Yes, I will. I'll shit right on the counter.
Hold up, before we hit this door, can we go to Taco Bell, please? I need some game fuel.
And depends.
All right, stop at a Target, too. I want to be classy.
So now what else do they have there? Do you remember what else they have that you're waiting to pick up or anything?
I saw a complete inbox Maniac Mansion.
Wow.
Getting away from the NES stuff, I could have sworn I saw in, like, a giant pile. I didn't get a chance to investigate because I was too busy looking for everything else. I'm, like, 85% sure there was a complete inbox Super Scope. It could have just been the box, but it was on the bottom and it didn't look crushed. So that's just what I saw while I was going through, like, the craziness. I know my friend Herb, Weeble Bullshit on Instagram, picked up a couple cool things. He got a Phantasy Star 3 for the Genesis for, like, $5.
Nice. Complete box. Whoa, really?
Yeah. Like, it was bad. Awesome. $5.
That's the best one out of the four of them, in my opinion.
He's going to be mad I just revealed that on the podcast because he doesn't like showing off his finds, but whatever. And Anthony got some stuff, too, but there was so much more we didn't have a chance to go through.
You should have just held them all. Just, like, give them all to the person all at once and just say, I will come back for these, and I'll be right back. Hold on. And then come back a week later.
Go blow people in parking lot with money.
PJ's going to be lucky if they let him back in the store after he shit everywhere.
Yeah. Well, she's a hoarder.
I'm sure Weeaboo Bullshit was crying because PJ probably shit on some fucking Japanese Dreamcast game.
I'm dead.
Oh, that'd make me cry too.
I have one Japanese Dreamcast game, and it's the Godzilla Generations game. But I love that game, even though it's terrible.
That game, even though it's terrible.
You heard me. Much like Jaws. All right,
I'm just making sure.
Hey, no, that's a good game.
Jaws is a good game. I'll be honest with you. I like that.
It's repetitive.
Yeah.
But it doesn't deserve the rainbow.
Yeah, I can see
that's
that.
That's right.
It's no X-Men.
Yeah.
That's a good thing.
All right, so Michael, what have you picked up recently?
Okay, I'm going to actually go back to last weekend when I found a game.com complete box for $6.
All right, I'm done.
I was pretty stoked to find that. But in terms of this weekend and this week, on Sunday I went with a buddy to our reseller friend's house where he recently bought out another local reseller and just bought all of his stock. So it was just a table full of boxes, full of games. The only thing is, for the most part, I knew what the other guy had. So I went in already knowing what I'm going to get. And essentially, I just traded a bunch of stuff that I found at thrift stores. Because this is the kind of reseller that will sell anything that makes a profit. So Harry Potter Viewmaster right. Reels, I think they go for like $13 on eBay, $26 on Amazon. It was gold for him. So I turned those into games, only spent maybe $2 total.
Who the hell plays Harry Potter Viewmasters?
Now, who's in the Viewmaster game that knows these? Yeah, I was going to say.
I just really hope that the reseller, like when he went to go buy out the other reseller, he went in there like, nah, you're giving me all your games, see? Nah.
Just... Yeah, I think they're working on a deal for like a couple weeks. But, yeah, all in all, I traded a bunch of random stuff that I found that was worth money, but it wasn't games, board games. The highlights were Goemon's Great Adventure, the idea of playing a 2D side-scroller platformer on the 64 just sounds awesome, seeing as how it's all 3D perspective games.
Wait, so you just got a Goemon game?
Oh, no. No, I posted everything I got the other day, but that was one of the highlights for me. As well as Shenmue for the Dreamcast.
Classic.
You know, and then what else? There's Batman, Return of the Joker. Just, you know, NES games that I needed. And then recently I made some trades with a local buddy and just picked up Terra Cresta, which I've been looking for. Putting me at 584.
Nice. Very nice.
So, you're getting there.
Yeah. So then I'm going on a little road trip this weekend, and you know, we'll see what else I could find.
I was supposed to go Saturday game hunting, but having three dentist appointments, one after another, has pretty much killed my bank account. So I will instead be sitting at home thinking of Michael as he goes out there shopping.
I'm sorry, buddy. The key is to go game hunting after your dentist appointment.
When you're still loopy enough that you don't know what you're buying.
No, that's actually bad, because I did that yesterday.
And then do a pickup video.
My dentist appointment yesterday, we actually went out to a pawn shop, and they had pretty much sports games, but in their little counter, they had a Goemon Mystical Ninja for 64. So I was like, how much? And he's like, 40. And I'm like, no. Ugh. Not happening. Nope. Card only. And he's like, well, that's what it's going for on eBay. And I pull it up and I'm like, no. There's another Goemon game for 64, which apparently goes for like 30 or 40. But this
great
is
adventure.
This is the more common
one. That's a great adventure, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I got the more common one, and I got it for, I talked him down to $15 plus tax. No, I'm sorry, $17 plus tax. I just wanted a game to make up for going to the dentist. So I got it, and I got home, and I was slightly not paying attention, because it's the whole back of the, like, the back label that gives all the, like, stupid information is all screwed up, and I'm like, why did I just pay $17 for this? I don't even like the 64. But I got a Goemon game, so that makes me feel like a person.
That's right.
And other than that, I have a friend who goes to Japan two or three times a year. Or probably like two times a year. Past few times he's went and got stuff for me. Well, he went this time. He didn't have as much luck this time. For instance, I was trying to get a bunch of Game Boy Lights. I was trying to get a Game Boy Light for me, Bent Lalo, and Bowser's King. I was also trying to get, John will have to tell you the name of it, some virtual wrestling game for the 64, and I was trying to get it for you, John.
Oh, sure.
But...
Oh, thank you.
He couldn't find it, unfortunately. So... Right.
That's
the,
okay.
The shop he normally goes to had been shut down. Apparently, they gave way too good of deals, and they couldn't last. So, he didn't get to find as much for me, but he did pick me up 5 Famicom games that are really good. I got Gunknack, Kid Dracula, The First Goonies, Salamander, which is Life Force in America, and the Final Fantasy 1 and 2 combo pack game.
So, nice.
I was pretty...
Are they Are they CIB? Or...
No, they're card only.
Card only, that's totally fine.
CIB in Japan is still really expensive. For instance, he found a completed box Ghosts and Goblins for the Famicom. But they wanted like $45 for it, and there's a chance putting it in a suitcase, it could get damaged to the box. So he pretty much skips on complete in box stuff because of it being pricey and, the chance of it getting damaged on the way here. He did bring me...
That makes sense.
Last trip, he took the risk and brought me Final Fantasy VI complete in box for the Super Famicom. So, every once in a while he'll take the risk if he finds the game cheap, but usually he doesn't find them cheap, so.
Alright. That makes sense.
I was curious, how does a Gunknack compare, like, in terms of value? Famicom and NES.
Listen, to break down the prices in the game, I paid $15 a piece for Kid Dracula and Gunknack. I paid $6.
Well, there you go.
I paid like $6 for Goonies. I paid, I want to say like $10 for Salamander, and I want to say I paid like $10 for Final Fantasy 1 and 2. He gives me the receipts, like, he goes, all right, here's all the receipts so you know what I paid, and it's all in yens, and I'm like, I don't know what the fuck this means. Like, but he does this every time, he'll give me the receipts like I know what that means. And if y'all don't know this, in Japan, Famicom games and Super Famicom games did not come out sealed. There is no sealed Famicom or Super Famicom games. But when you go over there and go to a used shop, they put a seal on everything, even loose carts. Everything gets sealed to keep it from getting damaged and dust. So if you ever see like a sealed, complete unbox Famicom or Super Famicom game, don't let them tell you it's sealed. It's not. It's a reseal. It most likely got resealed in a used Japanese game store. But like on the, they don't put stickers on the carts. They seal them and then they put the sticker on the seal. And then he hands all the shit to me and tells me, all right, you owe me this much, and I don't know what any of it means, so he then has to break it down to me. So, I don't know. Famicom games are cheap over there.
The cheap standard roll to yen to Americans, just move a decimal place over two spots. It's not exactly the same, but it's, yeah. If you paid 5,000 yen, it's about $50.
Yeah, that's what he
said. I mean,
like,
it's probably more closer to be $4.20. But.
I think, like, for instance, Goonies was the cheapest game out of them. And I think it was like 680 yen or something. And he was just like, yeah, move the decimal two spots and it's basically $6. And I'm like, okay.
Fine. It's bad. Yeah. But 15 for Gunknack. Can't go wrong with that. I mean, that's like a $80 yen right there. And...
Oh, yeah. That's.
Or is it more than that now?
Is it more than 80? For the American?
It floats.
Or...
I don't know. Yeah. I still really want the American Gunknack because I want to do a comparison of the two. But for $80, I'm gonna have to wait on it. And by wait, I mean wait
to come over to my place.
$120.
There you go.
Well, there's a good idea. Instead of buying the game for $80, I can buy a plane ticket to John's house.
There we go.
And then hang out over there.
I got
it. Play his and eat all his food for a week, and then come back.
Oh, I got that happens. It's all good. Well, and Kid Dracula, that's a cool game. I like how the first level is like every level of Castlevania.
I like how the first boss, when it came in, we're playing the game, a little guy in a sheet comes running out, looks like a kid in a ghost sheet, and we make a joke that, oh, it's the clan. And after you hit him once, he runs off, and then he comes back big, but he comes back big with a swastika on his head.
Yeah, and so it's a KKK guy. the swastika.
Yeah.
How much more can you make this offensive?
So, that was...
Here's what we hold. The site says, God hates fags.
Yeah.
Trying to...
Pretty much. So,
yeah.
That's all I got recently. I got a copy of Top Gun Second Mission for free, and I'm using it as a coaster right now, so...
And you didn't bring that up first?
That was my big reveal at the end. That, like, I got a new coaster. So, John, nice. What have you gotten recently?
Yes.
More jelly beans?
Recently, no. I still have some of those, actually. I bought a few of those last time I was at the store that I bought those jelly beans from. Recently, I picked up Lufia for Game Boy Color. That was part of a Nintendo Age auction. I admittedly haven't even played the Super Nintendo version enough to know the difference between the two. But it was in an auction. They're auctioning off other things at the same time. But here's Lufia, complete in box, that is just sitting there. And everyone else is after the other games, and nobody was bidding on it. So I threw out a bid early, didn't think anything of it. And then a week later, I get an email saying, hey, congrats, you won. I was like, oh, okay, whatever. So there's that. Worked out a trade. Somebody really wanted... I'm at the point now where it's almost like I'm collecting for other people, where I like the collections I have. I'm not really shooting for anything right now. Just kind of laying low. I'll pick up a couple things here and there. But I had a couple things that somebody really, really wanted. And he was like, dude, I will trade you. I have Eternal Darkness complete in box, Cube of War complete in box, both for GameCube. And then I have Mega Man Legends 2 for PlayStation. PlayStation 1, obviously. Also, you know, manual, everything, complete for those things. And I was like, it turned into a sure, I guess, because he really wanted those games. So it was more of a favor to him. And then in return, it's the people who are looking for Cube before. It's like, well, I basically picked him up for trade bait. I'll trade him off later, probably. So if you're looking for Cube before or looking for Mega Man Legends 2, I got him. If you want to work out a trade, maybe. And then our local game store has had Demon's Crest, which I don't have, but I'd love to get. So just using trade-in value of some stuff I had laying around here, a couple PlayStation 3 games and stuff like that. He can turn around PlayStation 3 games really, really easily. And he had a couple copies of Demon's Crest. So I just quick trade, gave him a couple of those. He gave me Demon's Crest.
Who has a couple of copies of Demon's Crest just laying around? Like, what is that, $80 now?
This was at my local game store.
Mm-hmm.
So I mean, he did, only because he was selling them for, I think he had them priced at $100. And there's going to be a little bit of wiggle room. So, I mean, so he prices high and more of a, it's if you want to buy it, but you're probably not going to buy it. But we have it, just in case.
And he can also, if he has it at 100 and he sells it for 80, he can act like he gave you the good, he can make you feel better about getting your game $20 off. So,
and I know him anyway. I mean, he's a, like, I probably like most people who are in game stores, he's a collector that turned into a reseller. So he kind of knows where things are, and I mean, I help him out, and he helps me out. So we kind of have a buddy system going on too. But he has that, so I grabbed that from him. And I was hoping to grab Chrono prices recently. Earthbound is dropped drastically ever since it was released for the Virtual Console,
mm-hmm.
And Chrono Trigger's shooting up in price now. Like they're almost about the same in price. I mean, like Chrono Trigger's like just under 100, while Earthbound is like you can find it for 100 or just over 100. So I'm probably looking out for that one. But this weekend is the Portland... this week, it's not Portland Retro Game Expo, but it's the Portland, Oregon, obviously. I'm on the West Coast. It's the Portland, Oregon, like, game swap. Like, it's like the Expo Junior, which is like, there's no panels. There's none of that. It's just a convention floor full of vendors, and you're also welcome to bring your own stuff. In fact, you're encouraged first to bring your own stuff to trade off to other collectors who are looking. So that's what's going on this weekend. So I'm bringing down, I still have a sealed Pikachu Pokemon Edition 3DS, so I'll probably bring that down there. I have a box full of game ColecoVision random stuff. I have a box full of box Intellivision system plus games and all that. So I'll bring over all the things that I don't need. Boxes of boxes. So I'm going to see what's going on there, and hopefully I can find some
some more finds.
Some more Game Boy happens. Games.
You know, I was looking for Game Boy games only because I only had a few of them, and now I have tons of them. And big thanks to Eric. I never know what people's screen names are. Eric something or other, Mr. Over 650 CIBJ Genesis games. He just recently. Yeah, it's Eric's with the one. He recently, I found a CIB Genesis game that he didn't have, and I sent it his way, just pro bono. I said bono, PJ, not boner. Just for free. I found this game for you. Here you go. And but again, I'm all about the schmoozing, and schmoozing isn't just I scratch your back, you scratch mine. It's I'll scratch your back, and I don't expect you to scratch my back, but if you do later on, that's great. But I don't expect it. And then sure enough, literally just yesterday, I had a package from him that was just some random Game Boy games to add to the collection. Not that I'm really looking for anything in particular, but I have been buying Game Boy games just because they're cheap. They're cheap unless they're expensive.
Yeah, like that's a big thing.
Which goes for everything.
That's a big thing in the RC community, is that there's a lot of that.
You're not really... There are some trades, but, you know, there's a lot more of just the, like... You know, like with you, Jerry, you know, you're like, oh, hey... You have the Contra Force manual. I was like, well, yeah, and if you want it, here you go. I don't need it.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, exactly. So. And, like, because of that, you know, when I was making my list of games to find in Japan, I was like, oh, you know what? John mentioned this wrestling game. I'm going to try to go for it. I didn't find it, but maybe. But it'll be on the list for next time. So if you don't get it by then, it'll be on the list.
It's the thought that counts, and I appreciate that.
Yeah. But, I mean, there's a lot of that. Like, I bought Org Battle 64 off Adam the Collector. I have a top 12 games I want to get in 2014, one for each month. That was the first one that I got for January. I went ahead and knocked one out. Well, when he sent it to me, he also sent me Mega Man 3 for the NES. I already have the game. And if someone sends me a game that I already have, I don't, like, for free, I don't like to use it in a trade. I like to kind of just pass it on. So, I was talking to Randy from Co-op Clothing about the shirts, and I told him, I was like, hey, I still need to get the last shirt I need, which is the red one, t-shirt version, because I have the tank top of it, John.
Of course you do.
Yeah, I have the red and white tank, because I'm that awesome. And I was like,
nice.
And I normally just buy the shirts from him. Even though he keeps trying to push them on to me for free, I won't let him. I'm like, no, you know, stuff like that you want to support. You know, you want to really support, you know, a fellow person going after their dream. So I like to support that. But this time I was like, well, I'm kind of short on money. Let me do a trade with you. For Christmas, my girlfriend got me Dracula X for Super Nintendo. So
awesome.
I have a bootleg of that game for the Super Famicom from Korea. That was given to me by another that I bought off another Instagram user. So I decided, hey, well, I'll trade you this game for the shirt because I pretty much paid what that shirt costs for the game. So and I told him, and I was like, do you have Mega Man 3? He's like, no. I'm like, I'm sending you Mega Man 3. So he's gonna get Mega Man 3 for free. But like that kind of stuff, it's not mandatory in the community, but you see so much of it. It gives me heartwarming genital feelings.
Oh, yeah, genital
feelings.
So, I like stuff like that. It's pretty
and it's
awesome.
Fun. So, I remember about a year ago, I was cleaning out my collection, and I was just like, I have all these. After I cleaned out my collection, it's more like about a year and a half ago or so. I had so many doubles of games that's why I just sought out on Instagram. I only posted it for like 15 minutes. But I was just like, if you're looking for any games, just let me know. I probably have it. If I have it, I'll send it your way. And then within those 15 minutes, I had about 20 emails of people saying, hey, here's the list I'm looking for. And sure enough, I had usually at least one game of someone that was. So, yeah, it's fun to give back to the community. I mean, I'm to the point now where, you know, if someone else really needs it for their collection, I promise you I don't. I'm okay with letting things go. So if it helps them out, I'm totally cool with that.
You know, I'm actually looking at the box copy of Shadow Squadron for 32X that John sent my way. So thanks, buddy.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
That one.
I feel like there's a joke here I don't know about.
No, there isn't.
No. There is
no it was just a nice little coincidence.
Yeah. It was. Yeah, that's right.
I mean, like, I can think about 2X. So many times that. Where, like, it's not gaming related, but, like, Bowser is King. I traded him the Jetsons for the NES for a Every Time I Die record set that's, like, was limited print. There wasn't a lot of them. It goes for way more than the Jetsons. But his brother used to work for Ferret, so he sent me that, plus, like, a bunch of Every Time I Die shirts that were all worn by him. So I got to put them on and just be Bowser's King, except with no beard. But,
He found him in a dumpster. I hope you realize that.
Well, no, these... I was really hoping it would, so I could be like, yeah, I've got that Trash Man treasure on. That new stuff. But, no, his brother worked for Ferret Records, so the label that Every Time I Die used to be on. So, he actually sent me a picture of him wearing one of the shirts, like, all outside and sweaty.
And I was like, that's what he sent you to. Yeah.
He was like, let me rub my beard on all this.
That's lovely.
It really is.
Blockbuster closed.
Oh, yes, it did.
Blockbuster videos are officially closed as of 5 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, probably 8 p.m. Eastern Time.
My Blockbuster membership card on eBay tonight to cash in on this.
That's right. No, that was my last pickup. Was I swung by there until the day of, and I tried to make a deal on the final day. I was just like, I'll give $50 for all the games that you have left on your shelf. And all they had left was, they had like 10 copies of DMC, DCM, whatever the fuck that game is called, the 360. Devil May Cry. And then they had Anarchy Rules. They had about 8 copies of that too. And I was like, you're not going to sell them anyway. They've been sitting there since whatever. They're 80% off anyway. I'll buy them all for $50. And even at that time, they were like, no, we can't do that. I was like, all right, well, have fun with your leftover games, I guess. But before all that, I did go in and I bought, you know, the rest of their stock of Wii U games. And then a couple of PlayStation games.
Let's talk about those.
Just because they were Wii U games. They're $4 each. Yeah. And it was, it was a Tekken Tag Tournament 2. And they had a couple of those. They had Assassin's 3. They had Black Ops 2. And then they had about 8 copies of Madden 13. And I only bought 4 of them because I don't even need one of them. But because they're $4 each, I went ahead and grabbed 4 of them anyway, just in case. And I'll pop it in once. I'll probably, you know, I live in Washington State, Yakima, Washington. This is Seahawks country. So I'll probably run a simulation of, like, here's what the game could look like, or here's how it could go down, you know, coming up for this Sunday or maybe leading into the Super Bowl, hopefully for people who watch the Seahawks or whatever. I don't really care, personally, myself, but my friends do around here.
Thank you, John, because you also picked up some Wii U games for me, and I'm pretty excited.
They're $4 each, and my plan was, like, I'll keep one of each for myself, because at the moment, I have... Super Mario Brothers Wii U. I don't even have the new one yet, but I picked up that one when I first bought the Wii, and that's the only game I have that I haven't downloaded. I have NES Remix and I have Wind Waker downloaded. Mm-hmm. But I was like, when I saw them for $4 each, I was like, well, this is a perfect opportunity for me to grow my collection 400, 500% all in one lot. And then the rest of them, I'm sure I'll trade them off or do whatever. And when you expressed interest, I was like, well, I'm not going to, you know, again, giving back to the community. It's like, well, I'll charge you what I paid for them plus shipping. Mm-hmm. So if it's, you know, $20 for 5 games or $20 for 4 games to grow your collection,
yeah, exactly.
Nothing wrong with that.
I was like, go ahead and grab Madden. It's $20. My girlfriend was like, why are you buying Madden? And I'm like, it's $4.
Because it's $4, yeah.
I might never play it.
Who knows?
It,
maybe it's fun.
It's $4 on my shelf that will look tasty.
Not that you babysit, but maybe if you happen to be somewhere and you have a friend who loves football games, like, oh, dude, hey, let's, you know, I'm going to check this out. You're like,
I'm not allowed around, like, children within, like, 40 feet, so.
Oh, all right.
I'm still allowed at your house, right, John? You know?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, no, for sure. My kids will love you.
Yeah.
Oh, and thanks, Sean, for posting the up about Blockbuster. Like, that same night, I went to my local one and found some stuff.
How funny really people sold great. Blockbusters?
Yeah,
How do we still have a
couple 360 games. There was one in my town. And it actually wasn't that far away.
Like 8 years.
Yeah, they've
been close for years, where you are?
No.
I ended up picking up 10 copies of the King of Kong.
Oh, yeah, I saw that.
That's awesome. No, I saw that. And those were probably like $1
each. Yeah. Yeah, so whenever I'm doing trades, I'm just going to pack them in. You know, great movie.
Yep. I searched mine also for the King of Kong. We didn't have any of those left. We probably all sent them to your store. But yeah, I don't know if it's a West Coast thing or what happened, but I mean, I live in Yakima, Washington. It's a population of maybe 80,000 proper. And we had three Blockbusters, but when one of them closed, they moved all the stock to another store. And then when that one closed, they moved all the stock to the other store. So it just kind of, you know, consolidated into one giant store. And then they finally turned it all off Sunday. So, but they also accused me of breaking and entering, so fuck them.
You did break and
enter. Wait, what?
To my heart.
Yeah, thanks.
Wait, okay.
No, it's a true story. And
you
yeah.
got breaking and entering. What, were you, did you not want late fees?
No, in the mid-90s, and this was when, and this was a great time. The mid-90s was such a good year for video games for a while. But it was during that time we had about three video stores within walking distance of each other. Four, if you count the little rental area that our local Safeway grocery store had. And they all had about the same games, but then you also knew which ones had specific games. Blockbuster was the one that had, like, the Blockbuster had the Virtual Boy. The other ones didn't. And they also had, like, a few Nintendo games and a few, like, I mean, obviously, they had, like, the White Guy, stuff like that. But I was there all the time anyway. But somebody, this is a true story, you know, from Yakima here. Somebody broke in with a, you know, shattered a window, crawled in there, grabbed a TV. This is not your flat screen paperweight TV. This is the old fashioned, like, Atlas trying to get the globe style television set. And then two Super Nintendos and two Genesis systems you could rent. And looking at this video, they thought it was me because the guy on the video and myself both had the same kind of coat.
Oh, wow.
So I actually, so it is, again, true story, just, you know, police on the door, knocking on the front door. I had no problem with the police, you know, talking to them. They come up and said, oh, we have reason to believe you broke into Blockbuster. And then they read me my Miranda rights, or whatever the fuck those things are called. And they took me down to the police station and they questioned me and they grilled me, and they're like, I know you did it, so just confess now. It's like, I don't know what you're talking about. I want a video. Give me the lie detector test. Of course, I took the lie detector test, and I passed with flying colors. But ever since that happened, I'm like, I'm not going to rent here ever again. And then I came back the final day and swiped up the rest of their Wii U collection.
This same logic that you're guilty because you wear the same coat is the same reason PJ is gay, because he has the same vagina as Edward from Twilight.
That makes sense.
I don't even know what to say to that.
I'm sorry, did I not? Should I have referenced Buffy? Is that the proper vampire story to go off of?
Whoa. Do not fuck around with Buffy.
I don't fuck around with bad things, so it's okay.
You know what? You know what? I quit. Podcast over.
All right, now
you can all go home.
Buffy's stupid. Anyway, so... That was good. Speaking of things that we do outside of gaming, Michael, how did your tour go? You went on a tour with your band. How did that go?
Yeah, I've toured about four times now. It's probably the best one, hands down. My band, Gorilla Stomp, went on a two-week tour up through California into Canada, and then made our way back down. You know, and I'll talk about the tour really quick, and then I'll talk about game hunting. We played 9 shows, saw a bunch of friends up in Canada. Right when we got into Oregon, I met up with, trying to get his Instagram name right,
Spacebar Zero.
Yeah, Flavio.
That's right.
And, you know, he hooked up a TurboGrafx and stack of NES games for a great price, and he even drove me around. Everyone else was kind of exploring Eugene, but he picked me up and, you know, showed me a couple spots. It was really cool. And then, you know,
I found Eugene?
A couple shops, you know, elsewhere in Seattle. There was Pink Gorilla, which was, you know, a ton of games. You know, it was not the best prices, but some were very reasonable. Then there was another store. I'm trying to remember what it was called. It was like Joe's CDs or something. It was in Seattle. John Pelham's.
Yeah. I'm trying to think.
Near the College District.
I mean, Pink. Yeah, U District. I mean, and Pink Gorilla is probably the most popular one in Seattle. And then the other one is Amazing Heroes. Not that you do Amazing Heroes at all. If you didn't, it's a crime against humanity.
Apparently, Michael didn't go to a store. He's the
one. It probably was nearby. Because basically, we would stop somewhere so they could go to some store. Yeah, I know.
No, I'm not familiar with the CDs.
We basically would stop somewhere. I mean, so I'd look up games, and if it was a mile away, I'd walk it. Yeah. But, you know, all in all, I found a lot of cool stuff, and the shows were awesome. And we came back down through California and played about 3 shows with our friends and Outside Looking In, another hardcore punk band. So it was good times. And we recently put out a 7-inch record, which was a bucket list item for sure.
Sweet. Well, I'm glad to hear that it went really well. I was pretty stoked. Yeah. I like when people in the community are doing something creative or outside to promote all of that. So going on tour is pretty awesome.
I'm bummed I didn't get a chance to meet you. I was hoping to hit up to Seattle that day, but I forgot what was going on that day, but I couldn't get away.
Yeah, like it seemed like all of our another dates were sure. Really like clear on the other side of you.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, definitely in the future we'll meet up.
There we go.
I know there's a lot of expos up there, so
we have 3 of them in this area. Oh, at least 3 of them in this area. So yeah, it comes in handy.
Sweet. And Riggs, you of course have started a YouTube series
that I promptly finished. All right, I haven't started it again, but I probably will here pretty soon.
Hey, I understand. YouTube series, like, I haven't done a new Game Case video in a while, so I feel you.
Yeah, no, just, you know, life gets busy, and you start doing other things, and you get the scare tactic of the, like, oh, they're going to shut down, you know, you can't show gameplay footage, and I was like, well, I'll take a little break right now anyway, I don't mind. No, just for fun, I forgot what I was thinking of, but I mean, and to say that it's a ripoff of Game Center CX is probably the most polite term. I mean, like, plagiarism is, like, almost like bowing in respect. It's a total ripoff of Game Center CX. But for me, it's all like, I don't care if I ever beat the game. It's always just that part of the game, can I just do that? And then I'll feel so much more accomplished. So I start, my wife and I were just talking one time. It's like, oh, it'd be cool if I just had, like, you know, just a challenge, just like, here's my challenge, and can I do this challenge? So then my wife and I started brainstorming. My wife also, she's not a gamer. She'll play Animal Crossing or Mario Party if it's on co-op. But outside of that, she doesn't really care so much. But she has a lot of great ideas. So we started brainstorming about, like, well, we can have, like, the retro challenge of, you know, in this episode, I'll play Mario Upside Down, or, you know, the Boy and His Blob episode that is probably the funnest one I've ever done. It's just like, every time I feed the blob a jelly bean, then I'll eat a jelly bean. And then we're like, well, let's take it a step further and grab one of those every flavor of jelly beans. That way it'll be, you know, funny or gross, or, you know, I'll be saved or something. So I'll do some more of those soonish. Yeah, sometime soon. I was happy when NES Remix came out. When NES Remix came out for the Wii U, I was like, this is it. If somebody made a video game on exactly what I do, this is the game. So I've been playing. Well, I was playing a lot of that until I, you know, there's nothing else I can do in that game anymore.
Well, but if you start doing game challenges with NES Remix, somehow we have to get like sperm flavored jelly beans to incorporate in there, because I don't think you tasted enough bad things.
I wouldn't even know what that tastes like. You'd have to PJ would have to tell me.
PJ,
it's delicious. I don't see how this is a punishment.
Okay. PJ, I will lose on purpose. Just
PJ is starting his own jelly bean company.
Oh yeah,
nice
semen beans.
Nice, yeah.
I feel like he's had that name for a while, just waiting to use it. Oh, one of these days, semen beans will come up to be a real
jelly
thing.
Jellies.
That's right. Semen beans is now trending on Twitter. If you look up the hashtag.
What?
No, so Riggs Retro Challenge on YouTube. There's a few of them that are on there right now. There's actually not many. There's maybe five or six, but I'll kick it back up here and do some more here in the near future.
Well, I definitely am pretty stoked to see more because I find them funny, especially the ones where you have just this face of awfulness. Those jelly beans were great. I hope you do more of those.
Yeah, I don't know about the jelly beans one. Well, I could do I do have a boy in his blob for the Game Boy. I do like the trouble in, what the hell is that game called? The Rescue of Princess. Yeah, well, that one's the first I think.
Oh yeah,
Princess. It's the Game Boy version. I do have that one, so maybe I'll do it again via the Super Game Boy, so I can channel it through and patch it through the computer.
Hmm.
Or I could just play the emulator, I guess. But the emulator again. That's the reason I don't play emulating as a retro gamer, is because it's not the same. The timing's a little off, just a little bit, and I can't do it.
Yeah, I don't know.
Or it's not perfect.
We have always used emulators for the game case just because I don't have the outside software to record straight from a console, but I can record straight off my computer, so we just do it off there. But then again,
that's a great thing to do.
Yeah, and most times when we do it, it's like for our challenge accepted videos, and half the time those are either me sucking at Lion King or they're fighting games where we see who's better at which fighting games. We're all terrible at them.
Right.
So either that or the drunk challenge accepted, because drinking makes it always good.
Yeah, I'm drinking right now, actually, so it works out all right. That's why I think that's hilarious, and I'll listen back to it later. I'm like, no, that was actually pretty stupid.
Is it semen bean flavored?
Well, I wish.
PJ.
Actually, almost.
IPA.
It is.
It's a semen IPA. So,
almost.
John,
no, this
does,
is the
does your
Portland
wife
Brewing
know
Company.
About your semen drinking?
Yeah. Oh no, she would join in if she was around to hear what's going on.
Not when she
knows all
that.
Oh,
Italian.
Yeah.
Oh, PJ. PJ, how hard is it to be a gay Italian? Like in the.
She'll listen back to this here. She'll have some comments.
It's extremely difficult because I talk with my hands twofold.
Does you're in the same kind of area that Hatter Marie's in a little bit. I know she's a little bit farther up north than you, but does she get mad that you take all the guys?
The times we've held at conventions, we've been too busy looking for games to be worried about sexual guests, but I'm pretty sure she wins in that regard.
I don't know, PJ. You got the, them old school internet lips, that DSL.
Oh yeah.
I wish AOL was still a thing. Speaking of which,
it is still a thing apparently.
No, it's not. Shut up. It is not a real thing.
I just went to AOL back home on my phone. It is a thing.
PJ, I can still go to the website for Space Jam. Okay. I don't care about your internet relics. Speaking of relics, though. How's everyone feeling about this rumor of Shaq Fu 2?
I am stoked.
PJ, you haven't heard about this?
No, I have, but I want it in my mouth.
and or around your mouth.
I want to devour the sequel to Shaq 2. Shaq Fu.
Yeah, apparently...
No, I just saw...
John, do you know more information on this? Who's got the info on this?
Oh, I don't. No, I heard the rumor just like anyone else, and I literally just saw someone maybe 2 weeks ago on Reddit who had the... they actually had the Shaq Fu collection, so they had it CIB for Super Nintendo, Genesis, Game Gear, even Game Boy, and I was like, out of all the collections you could have, that's actually pretty funny. And they could take it a step further, because, I mean, like, Michael Jordan had Trouble in the City, or whatever the Michael Jordan game was. You know, there's other, like, other, games, too. I thought it was a collection.
Yeah, I don't know. I'd play a Shaq Fu, too. I hope it has online play, though, to be honest, because I want to kick your ass at Shaq. But that's just me. There was... also another game that's surprisingly coming back. Super Noah's Ark 3D is apparently getting a re-release.
Really?
Which I'm sure Mike was the blank for this one.
I'm actually pretty stoked on that.
Yeah, they're saying it was like 60. They said it was like 60, but I'm seeing stuff now that's saying it's like $40.
Christian Wolfenstein. But yeah. $60, I don't know. You know, but it is cool that they are looking to re-release an actual Super Nintendo game. I mean, the closest thing that we have right now is that DuckTales card that came out, the gold one.
Yeah, well, my biggest issue is, well, I'm hoping that it definitely looks different than the original card, which I think I saw that it's actually now just a standard gray Super Nintendo card. Because... fakes have been becoming more and more of an issue, and they're going to continue to be more and more of an issue. I don't know if recently y'all saw the thing where the guy in Europe bought a copy of Flintstone Surprise at Dinosaur Peak just to get it. The label looked fine, but he opened it up, and it was a fake ROM. It was not original.
Yeah. That happened to me. That happened to me with a Little Samson.
Or it's a Famicom adapter.
Wait, it happened to you with Little Samson?
Yeah, I bought a fake one once. Did you see that?
No, that's... oh, crap. Tell me more. I want to know about this.
Okay, here's what I did, and then here's my logic, because you're gonna hear the first part of it, and you're going to say, okay, John Riggs, a.k.a. John Blue Riggs, I had a lot of respect for you until I heard you did that, and now I know you're a fucktard, and don't talk to me ever again, because I knew... because well, what you did was stupid.
Well, but I think you're a fucktard if you use first. The word fucktard, but other than that.
That being said, and not to be withheld, is through a pawn shop, through an Amazon store, somebody posted, and I was just casually looking, just, you know, you look up, I was like, oh, I'm just sitting around, happen to see if they have something on eBay, have to see if they have something on Amazon, and a Little Samson popped up on Amazon. For it was around $250. Between $250 and $300. And it was Little Simpson. And they didn't have a picture of it, but they had the email address, and it was from a pawn shop in New Jersey, of all places. And I was like, well, it's worth looking into. Email address, I'll drop him an email saying, hey, do you have a picture of that game? And that's when he said, well, here's the picture of it. And he said, I have to let you know that person I bought it from.
Hello.
Taking the gamble. Yes?
I don't know. You like it stopped mid sentence on my end from when you said when you asked him about a picture.
I asked him about the picture of it. He said, "Well, here's the picture. He emailed me a picture." And he said, I have to let you know that the person I bought it from put a different label on it. And that red flag that says it is definitely a fake. But I would for it anyway, just in case. Because again, $250 for Little Samson, we'll see. We'll see what happens. Did the transaction through Amazon. I sent him the money. He sent me the game. Came with the case. Came with the shitty label. Sure enough, oh, back of it, it was a fake. Now here's where the fun part comes in, and why I was smart enough, never mind the red flag, was because it was on Amazon has don't fuck around policy, basically, where it's like, if you're selling the wrong thing, if you're selling a fake, we'll shut your ass down quick. Mm-hmm. So I wrote back saying, hey, by the way, that cart was a fake, so I'm going to send it back, and you send the money back. And then he was like, no, please, no. Do not leave me a bad review for my pawn shop through Amazon. This is my Amazon store. Keep the cart, and I'll send you back the money. So I was like, well, okay. But then he also, again, another red flag. He said, but I'm going away for about a week, so when I come back a week later, I'll make sure I send the money back to you. I said, you know what? Fine. So week passes. I even let 2 weeks pass. Nothing happens. Send him an email. Before, the emails were flying in. I'd send him an email. He'd send a reply back within minutes. This time around, didn't get an email back. Tried again the next day saying, hey, by the way, I never heard back from you. I seriously don't mind sending the game back, but I am going to get my money back. And still didn't hear back from him. So that's when I went to Amazon. And then Amazon, of course, took about not even 24 hours before they sent a reply back saying, we gave you your money back to your account, and I still kept the game. So I got my money back, and I also have.
So you have a fake little Samson.
Fake little Samson sitting in my collection. I don't count it in my collection, obviously, but I have a fake little Samson, and also. I have a fake little Samson, and thanks to our buddy, our friend at Insta80s, they also gave me a much better looking label. But this label is also really not a real label.
Sweet. Well,
it's like you can tell it's not official. Official if I wanted to, but also for the sake of I don't see if down the line I give it away or resell it. So yeah, always make sure. Always make sure. I do have a Flintstones Surprise at Dino Peak that I also did open up. And fortunately, that one is the real deal that I also got for a great price. But yeah, too many red flags will say no, but because it was through Amazon, I knew that I'd back. If something happened, again, taking the gamble, just in case, I got my money back, and I also got to keep the card. So, yay! For long, boring stories.
Well, I mean, it serves a good lesson, though, because you got to be careful about that stuff. especially now, especially buying off eBay, there are a lot of, it's so easy to fake a game now. You can go on eBay, you can buy kits that are like for your own personal use and collection, but really people are buying it and faking games, putting fake labels on them, which, I mean, if it's for your own personal collection, if that's what you want to do, sure. My only issue are the labels that don't say reproduction on there or have something that shows very clearly it is not the original label.
Right. I've seen even there's like the asterisk after the title. There's just something that's small enough that's like just a little cue that says, yeah, it looks official, but if you look close, you know that it's not the real deal. And props tell you up front on it, but to hell with the guys who
yeah, so it's just something to be careful about, but it's always a risk sometimes, even when you're on a flea market. You never know if you're going to buy a game and it not work. You never know if you're going to buy it off eBay and it be a fake. That's the game you play. So, but anyway, that's our time for this week. Thanks, everyone, for listening. We will be back again. We'll have another retro roundtable featuring all of us or maybe even more different people. We don't know what will happen in the future. We'll see.
AIDS.
Did you just say AIDS?
Yeah. AIDS will happen in the future. I predict it.
What the fuck is wrong with you, PJ? Just because you're gay and have AIDS doesn't mean that the rest of us need it, man. Some of us have kids.
Well,
they're not my kids, but I have
AIDS. Well, by extension, you have AIDS. By extension, you have AIDS.
How do I have AIDS?
Same reason.
Hey, if I close my eyes, it never happened. But anyway,
you know what?
That's it for us. Thank you, everyone, for watching. We'll see you on the Facebook group and the Instagram for all the wonderful times we have. But this is the Retro Collective Podcast, and we will see you next time. If everyone wants to say bye, go for it.
MySpace.
Okay, you know what, PJ? Did you really just say MySpace? This is why we can't have nice things.
I'll see you on LiveJournal.
Michael, I swear to God, if you say vampire, Zing. We're going to fight. You people and your stuff. Okay, we're out.
Follow Black Planet.
Did you say Black Twitter? Okay, PJ's turning out to be Kanye West, so we're out of here. Thanks, everyone, for watching.